In this video, we are going into the programming of a live show and building a workspace. The default workspace comes with plenty of cues, waves, sheets, cones, boxes, hot beams, fans of beams, and static images. These are all atmospheric cues made to be seen in the air, unlike graphics cues. We're going to get out of the default workspace and open up My Workspace, which has custom built pages in addition to the default cues. This allows me to have a more custom look to my show and gives me more flexibility with the workspace. You'll see on my main page I have cues that are as simple as a couple static beams in the air to play along with the melody, cues that are one hits, and cues that move to the music. Effects allow you to further modify the cue that you're playing. Effects can adjust color, movement, size, zones, and many other aspects of what your audience sees. You can trigger these live using quick effects below, and then sliding up the effects action slider, or by adding an effect to the cue itself. If you're adding it to the cue, this will come up every time you play the cue unless it's disabled. I like to add effects to cues so that I spend my time playing the cues along with the music and lighting rather than figuring out what effects to add at the bottom before the song drops. The more pre-show work you do on your workspace, the better your shows will look on the fly. I like to create custom cues to make my shows unique. My process typically starts by right-clicking an open cue and clicking Create New Synthesized Image. As an example, we're going to make a circle of beams that opens and moves to the beat. Create a new shape and set it as a circle. By clicking this button, we can change the shape from line mode to beam mode. First, we're going to adjust the size to 30. We also want to reduce the points in the shape to prevent flickering. This slider adjusts how many points are in the shape. We're going to set it at 10. Over here, we're going to add a couple of oscillating effects. Oscillating effects are effects that can match the master beat clock that you set while listening to music by tapping the space bar to the beat. These are essential for beat matching lasers to music. The first oscillating effect will be oscillating zoom. It defaults to size 10 to 100, ping-ponging every beat. We're going to change these parameters to make it open from 50% size to 100% size on every beat, and have the motion run linear rather than ping-pong. To make the action take up more or less beats, enter the desired amount here, but we're going to leave it at 1. The second oscillating effect will be an oscillating position x-axis. This defaults to ping-ponging negative 50 to 50 every beat. We actually want the cue to move left to right over 4 beats, but rather than moving the whole time, stick at 4 different spots during the beat. I'll change ping-pong to 4 discrete steps, and the beats to 4. Finally, to add some color, we're going to add a color effect. And over here, adjust it so it changes color based on radius, rather than points. Now after messing with the effect a bit more, we can have the circle get more red as it gets larger. When done creating your cue, just click OK, and your cue is ready for live use in your workspace. Another part of your Beyond workspace can be the universe. The universe is a customizable tool that allows you to set the interface you interact with during the show. This includes sliders, buttons, knobs, DMX control, and visualization with video and pictures set as the background. As an example, we're going to create a brightness slider and an XY position controller. To add components to your universe, click Edit, and then click the Components tab. For the brightness slider, we need to place a slider component on the universe. We can use these points to change the size of our slider to fit our needs. Under the Inspector tab, we see the preferences for the component that is currently selected. Since we want this to affect the master brightness of our workspace, we scroll down to Link to External Object and select Master, Brightness, and click OK. Since master brightness can have a value from 0 to 100, we need to adjust our values in the universe to a max of 100 and a minimum of 0. Now when we click play on our universe, we are able to move the slider and affect the brightness. The idea is similar for the XY position graph. Place the component on your universe, and under the Inspector tab, have it affect master X position and master Y position. Set your values to a minimum of negative 100 and a maximum of 100, and you're good to go. You can also use the universe as a visualizer. Here I have placed virtual projectors at the same spot they were during the real show, and the zones for each projector overhead. As I play cues, you can see what it would look like on top of a photo of the show. This is a great way to show clients what you're thinking when it comes to laser placement. Click here to watch an hour-long in-depth webinar on the advanced levels of customizing your universe.